Hello students, welcome to your Maths 1 online teaching session. Let us continue with our 7th chapter, that is statistics. We have nearly reached to the end of the chapter. In this session, we will learn about measures of central tendency. Let us quickly see the definition of it. Central tendency. If the data collected in a survey of a group is sufficiently large, then it generally shows a peculiar property. The numbers in the data tend to cluster around a certain number. This property is called as central tendency of the group. Now this is the theoretical definition. You will understand much better, don't worry, when you will solve sums based on this. Let us understand the definition once again. Suppose you are collecting data of large number of students for some particular purpose. You will find that data which you have collected will show a peculiar property. What property it will show? That all the numbers in the data will cluster around a certain number. This property is actually called as central tendency of the group. And the number around which the numbers in the data tend to cluster. Tend to cluster means what? They will be nearly same to that particular number. I am not telling exactly same, approximately same. Okay? Those numbers will tend to cluster around a certain number. And that is nothing but measure of central tendency of the group. Okay? Yes. So, in this chapter, what we are going to learn is measures of central tendency. Three types, that is mean, median, and mode. Now, these three concepts are not only important this year, but even next year you will be learning much in detail about them. Next year you will be getting different methods to find mean, formulas for median and mode, and so on. Then what are we going to learn this year? This year we will be introduced to the concept, the definitions of mean, median and mode, and maybe few simple sums based on very easy formulas. Okay? Right. So in today's session, we will be starting with the first central tendency, that is mean, in detail. Okay? And remaining median and mode will continue in the next session. So let's start with the first central tendency, that is mean. I am giving you an example before we start with the concept. Let's see the example. Consider the following example. Calculate the average of the following numbers. The numbers are 25, 30, 27, 23 and 25. Okay. So now read the question again. Is this word new to you? Calculate the average? Definitely not. Average you have learned in 7th or 8th standard. Yes or no? I am just revising that concept. So please everybody solve it in your book and check your answer afterwards from the slide. Calculate the average of these numbers. What are you going to do when you want to calculate average of given numbers? I hope you remember it. Average is nothing but the sum of all these observations. What are the observations? 25 plus 30 plus 27 plus 23 plus 25. The sum of all these observations upon what? Yes, few might get confused and might write 2 here, but that is not correct because we are not finding any midpoint. We are going to find average, and average, the formula is sum of all observations upon number of observation. Now number of observation means what? See how many numbers are given to you here. 25 means 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Number of observations is 5. I hope you are understanding it and in fact revising this concept. You already know this, right? So, when I add this, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 7, 15, 15 plus 0 is 15, and 15 plus 5 is 20, so 0 here, carry up 2, so 2 and 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, 13, so it comes to 130, 130 upon 5. When you divide this, you will get 2s and 6s. 26 is the average of this given numbers. Now, this is absolutely not a new concept. It's just a revision of what you have already learned in the previous years. So, this was the formula. Average is equal to mean of all observations in the data upon total number of observation. Okay. So, this was the formula. Then, substitution of the values, as I have already done and shown to you. It comes, the total comes to 130 and the answer is 26. Now, why I am stressing so much on average? Because average in statistics is nothing but the first central tendency, that is mean. So this is what we are going to learn. It's just the revision of the concept. Mean and average are one and the same. When it is same, when you have like this ungrouped numbers and numbers are very less, like I have given you only 5 numbers here, 5 observations, and all are ungrouped. So when you have like this, then you can use this formula of average, which you already know, for calculating mean as well. So average in statistics is nothing but mean, and the formula is sum of observations upon number of observations. So that is the reason I was revising all this concept of mean that you have already learned. Okay, so now let's see the definition of mean. Now that you have understood that average and mean are one and the same, so what is the definition? The arithmetical average of all observations in the given data is known as arithmetical mean. Average is nothing but mean, or simply you can call it as mean. Okay, so if concept is same, the formula also has to be same. The formula for mean is, I want you to write this definition as well as the formula, sum of all observations in the data upon total number of observations. Okay, same as average formula. Okay, now this is when observations are ungrouped. What if observations are grouped? Then we will be learning a new method that I will be telling you, don't worry. Now for now, what you understand is, when the observations are ungrouped, you have to use this formula of average for calculating mean also. That is sum of all observations in the data upon total number of observations. Now with this knowledge, let us further with practice set sum, that is practice set 7.5, question number 1. Now yield of soybean per acre in quintal in Mukund's field for 7 years are 10, 7, 5, 3, 9, 6 and 9. Find the mean of yield per acre. Now, I hope you understood this. This is very easy. It's actually average that they are asking us, because see, the observations are ungrouped and there are quite less number of observations. You can use the formula for mean which I gave you just now. What was the formula? Mean was sum of observations upon number of observations. So mean can be written as, now sum of observation, all observations, right? So it is 10 plus 7 plus 5 plus 3 plus 9 plus 6 and plus 9. All these observations I have written. Then number of observations. Now do I really need to count it? No, because it is given here. For how many years? 7 years. So number of observation is 7. So you need to count all this and then divide it by 7. So by counting, you will find that the total is 49. And when you divide it by 7, answer you get as 7. So this is nothing but mean that I have calculated. I hope this concept is clear. Yes, it's very easy, similar to average calculation. So now there are two ways of presenting the answer. This is one of the way, that if you feel that writing all these numbers together in the formula and then taking total will be difficult, you can simply do it separately like this. Sum of all observations, add it and get the total. Number of observations, it's given as 7. Anyways, you can count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So number of observations 7. Sum of observations as 49. Then you use the formula. Formula, as I have told you, mean is equal to sum of all observations in the data upon total number of observations. So this is the formula. You can substitute directly like this in the formula, as sum of observation is given as, I have separately done it as 49, and number of observation I have written here as 7. So the answer will be 49 upon 7, that is 7. Or as I have told you, you can even write the formula. First step can be write this formula, and next step in the formula only you can add it like this. Okay, so 10 plus 7 plus 5 plus 3 plus 9 plus 6 plus 9. All this you can add directly in the formula. Upon 7, divide it, answer again you will get as 7. I hope this concept is clear to you. It is not at all difficult. It is not at all new concept. It's just the revision of average. Yes, so mean is equal to sum of observations upon number of observation. Once you have done all this, what is left is to write the final answer. Final answer will be mean of yield per acre is 7 quintals. Okay, so these are the steps to be followed while presenting the answer in the exam as well. Always have the habit of writing the formula, putting it in the box. Presentation matters, learn it. Okay, then substitution and then answer and then final answer with the unit. This was yield in acre in quintals, so you write yield per acre is 7 quintals. I hope everything, the concept, the formula and this one sum from the practice set is nicely understood to you. Okay, now we will continue with the remaining part of the chapter, that is remaining central tendencies, median and mode, in the next session. As I have already told you, mean, one more method I have to tell you when it is grouped, that I will be teaching in the next session. Complete your book till here. Thank you.